If you find yourself liking this video, please give it a like, and make sure to share, subscribe, and click that bell. Goal to 100, let's go. Hello everyone, I'm RyanX1000, and yes, I was selected to partake in the Elden Ring closed network test. I have a screenshot right here to show proof that it was on my PlayStation. Yes, I did play it. Those are my games, that's me up there. And, you know, I was trying to record videos of Elden Ring. I was trying to get footage in. Unfortunately, for some reason on the PlayStation, it is the game. Elden Ring is a blocked scene, so I couldn't record anything. Anyway, I just want to say, guys, it's a crazy game. It is awesome, and I am going to have some spoiler warning. I am going to be spoiling some stuff about the closed network test in case, you know, if you guys don't want to hear anything like that, then click away. If you don't mind spoilers, then keep listening. So, it started me off in some sort of dark, decrepit dungeon of sorts, where I was getting tutorial hints on how to play the game. And I'm just going to say, the first thing I did, I pressed the X button. I had to make sure that I wasn't imagining things, that there was a jump button. And yes, there's a freaking jump button. I was so happy about that. Oh my gosh, to finally have a jump button in a Dark Souls game. Anyway, okay, sorry. Guys, the world, it is so expansive. It is so fun to explore everything. I already found about 6 checkpoints so far. I don't know how much more I'm gonna be able to see in more sessions of the network test. I don't know if more areas are gonna be unlocked or I can only just stay in the small area and level up. One of the first enemies I encountered when I was trying to explore the world and everything, well, it was a mini boss, or maybe it was a regular boss, I don't know, but it's right when I left the dungeon, there was this really big guy on a horse, and he was hard. I was just like, wow, I've played Dark Souls 3 many times, I've been playing Dark Souls 1, I've played Bloodborne a lot. I thought I was prepared. Guys, Elden Ring, it's a whole different beast. I was so surprised. I don't know why I thought it was gonna be like easy, as in like Dark Souls 3 easy. I thought it would be something around the lines of Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne difficulty. No, this is like, it's like Sekiro. The difficulty is pretty similar to what I experienced in Sekiro, which I still need to beat. And, you know, that's one thing I want to mention is that there's so many elements from all the different games you can find in here, such as the attributes. Some of them, actually one of them I think, which is basically the luck stat in Dark Souls, is called Arcane like it was in Bloodborne, which I thought was kind of cool. Also, it seems like the different playstyles you can go with, you can be fast and aggressive like in Bloodborne, especially since you have a lot more stamina to work with in Elden Ring as opposed to the Souls games. And it regenerates really quickly, so combat isn't as stamina heavy, which kind of helps with if you want to go for a more Bloodborne-ish playstyle, you know, fast and aggressive. But then at another point in the game, I was able to go up against some knights and more warrior type guys, and I was able to play it like Dark Souls. So more methodical, hiding behind the shield, waiting for your opening, and, you know, circling around the enemies to get backstabs. I was able to do that, and I took down those guys really quickly. Now, I have yet to see more enemies where you have to play it like Sekiro, where you have to time blocks, or you just have to have the same mindset as you would be playing it in Sekiro. I will say that the stealth mechanics from Sekiro, I was able to pull off in that same area, actually, where the warrior guys were. I was able to sneak around and kill them. And so I was able to be a shinobi, and it just seems so great that I can do the 3 playstyles of the 3 games. And we can do it all. It's so cool to see. There's definitely a good amount that I can keep covering, but I think I'll just leave it as is for now, just for us to start discussing, and, you know, we can talk to each other in the comments. I'm actually going to be going into my next Elden Ring session for the network test, because it's about to be 7 o'clock, so the servers are going to be starting up soon. I'm going to be going into that right now, and yeah, hopefully I can see you guys next time. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and stay awesome.